What? We're playing Russian roulette now? Hi, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Belly Oh So Pregnant. We are going to talk about the thing. I'm going to call it the thing. You know, that thing that people are talking about. I cannot say the name because if I do, this video might not exist anymore. So that thing, it's been going around the talk. I was in the car yesterday and I don't really listen to the news that much. And they were talking about it. They were talking about it with pregnant women. And it was like, so there were like three women doctors, of course, on the radio station talking about it and basically just encouraging women to go ahead and get it. And it was about 45 minutes long. And I was just sitting there like, I should record right now. But I was in the middle of doing, you know, errands and things like that in and out the car. But I'm here today to say that, first of all, it's only been a year and a half. It hasn't even been 2 years yet. And anybody who's in medical or graduated in some kind of medical pre-med or whatever knows that they usually say that any kind of clinical trial, a good one, is going to take about 7 years to really get that data. And it hasn't even been 7 years yet. So basically, we're going off of speculation. Basically, we're going based off of fear of the unknown. And my question is, if something is an unknown and if something is not seen, how are you able to treat that if it's unknown and it's not seen? It's kind of puzzling. And I'm here to tell you that you are responsible for your temple. You are responsible for your family. You are responsible for the baby that's growing inside of you. So whatever decisions that you make, it is your choice, your decision, and then whatever happens after, you're the only one to blame because you do have a choice, whether or not you think you don't have a choice because of all the pressure that's going on, you do have a choice. So if something is new, rapidly formed under the circumstances of we don't know, it's unknown, it's deadly, but and it floats in the air. I'm sorry. It floats in the air. So all these things are happening at a rapid pace. Now they want to go ahead and say, hey, let's treat the pregnant women too. Really? Why? You know what I mean? Because just in case, you're pumping a deadly active virus into a system. And you're just hoping that everything will work out at the end. But what if it doesn't? Who to blame? Them or you? You. Not them. You. So I know a lot of things is on the line now. Money, finances, stability, food, just your basic necessities to live. Water. Don't be surprised if we run out of water. Last year was toilet paper. This year might be water. But the basic needs are being rattled. And anytime anybody's basic needs are being snatched away, it causes a panic. And they know this. So calm down. Take a couple breaths. Turn your TV off. Look at my videos that I did last year. I'll put them down in the description after this. But click on those and just look about what I was talking about, what was going to happen this year. And it happened. So take your time with it, just like a clinical study. Don't rush. I understand you might lose out on some things, but there's always opportunities to do other things. You lose your job. Okay, well, maybe this is a good time to become an entrepreneur or to start and look for another job. Because if you look everywhere, there's jobs hiring everywhere from food to even medical. They're using students that haven't even graduated yet to replace the nurses and the doctors since everybody is either walking or getting fired by not participating in this speculation that doesn't have a concrete conclusion. If you remember, I think it was in the 1950s or the 1960s, if I'm not mistaken, but they had an issue with pregnant women and giving them a drug that the government and the medical and everybody said it was safe, but come to find out, it caused so much defects within the babies that even now today, there's lawsuits behind it versus what happened, you know, 1950s, 1960s, because these kids was born with no limbs, a whole bunch of other things, cleft palates, you name it. So why would you put your child at risk, you at risk, to fight off something deadly to see if it worked or not? Clinical trials are very difficult when it comes to pregnant people because you're experimenting on two people, an unborn and the mother. So they really like hands off on clinical trials. That's why they usually test a lot of Caucasian men as their results. But now that since people are being more aware and being more knowledgeable and want more concrete information, they're opening up the study for it to be done on pregnant women. Now, numbers can be manipulated. Tests can be manipulated. That's something that we learned in medical school. Okay? Not every study is accurate, especially if it can't be repeated over and over again. And at this desperation, people just want to put whatever they want to put out, like a snap of what it is. Instead of the whole story, it's just one little snap of what the possibilities could be. And of course, they're going to choose the positive side just to get you to come in. But if your body, your beautiful, wonderful, magnificent body can fight it at like 98%, just like it does all the time. We touch germs all the time. You touch doorknobs. You touch the elevator buttons. You touch rails. You touch everything. You touch fruit that somebody's been touched at the grocery store and put it back, but then you came behind them and put it up, and you might have ate it. You know what I mean? Because sometimes when you're hungry, you don't wash that apple. You know, you don't wash that peach. You don't wash that. You probably rub it on your shirt and you keep going, right? So every day, even the air, there's still so much airborne stuff out here. It's pathetic. But your body is designed beautifully, which they're still trying to understand to fight it. So I know you're worried. Oh, I want to get it because it's going to boost my immune system and my baby's going to have some of that boost in their immune system as well. Okay, but your body already does that, especially if you breastfeed. It's going to have that efficiency that no drug can ever duplicate. So why mess that up? For the unknown? And then what, you're going to sue? There's going to be a lot of lawsuits. A lot of lawsuits coming out within the next, you know, now to 20 years from now. And of course, they're going to tell you to do what they say to do. And of course, all the medical industries is going to follow that because they don't want to lose their job. They don't want to lose their job. So, and then they want to keep their credibility and all of that. Their finances, of course, you don't want to lose your doctor job. That's, come on now. You went through all them schooling for what? So of course, you're going to go along with the flow. But then what's the repercussions of going along with the flow? Now, I don't want to hear nobody complaining 20 years from now because there's enough information out there, videos, even if it's not from what you call credibility people, but the people who was on the streets is talking and they're talking really loud and the other side is trying to get louder than the people. And I'm here to tell you, use your discernment. Don't rush. You'll be completely fine. The exact same thing that I'm telling all pregnant women. Wash your hands. Anyway, 3 years ago, I would have said the same thing. Stay away from people who are sick. Anyway, don't go anywhere if you're sick. Anyway, you know what I mean? So just the basic things that we're supposed to do. Anyway, if you do those things and keep up your wonderful diet, you know, with your mixtures of your vegetables, your fruits, your meats, your proteins, you know, your vitamins, you'll be A-okay. Rest when you need to rest. Don't overexert yourself. Stay hydrated, and your body will do the rest. If you give your body what it needs on a daily basis, it will do that 98%, and it will pass that on to your baby as you nurse. So, once again, check my videos out for last year. I can't really say so much because now everything is being compromised on social media. They're starting to delete everything with that name in there. So I'm just trying to speak in code. The FDA is not always right. Check your research. History does repeat itself. It's like a cycle. Everything new, everything under the sun is not new. You heard that? Right. The doctor is not always right. You heard that? And medical industry is not God. The medical industry is not God. Look at all the lawsuits. How do they know what's good for the pregnant woman? Because from my view, from what I've seen, from the numbers, it don't look like they was concerned about pregnant women before. Our cesarean section is up 30-something%. The mortality rate is up, especially when it comes to people of color that has some little tint in their skin. So if they wasn't working so hard on getting those numbers down prior, a year and a half ago, which a lot of doulas and midwives have been talking about for so long, and there's some OBs and some others who've been advocating for pregnant women and the freedom to not be intervened and let their body do what it does because it's perfectly designed, and everybody's still trying to figure out how and why, because they're not God or gods. Take control of your health. Take control of your temple. You are responsible for your temple. And whatever you produce, whatever you create, you're responsible for that too. So don't rush. Because of loudness, because of the force, you are stronger than what you know. And trust me, you will be so happy 20 years from now that you trusted your body over somebody telling you you need this to help your body. If you have any questions, comment below. You can also email me as well. And I will keep in touch with you guys. I know I've been very busy here and there, you know, being a mom and everything that's going on and blah, blah, blah. But yes, keep in touch. Holla. Have a conversation below. And I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.